G'day, I'm Shaun.
And I'm Simone, and this is our mate, George the Farmer.
Now we've travelled from down south all the way to the tropics of far north Queensland to discover something sweet as.
Sweet as, that's right, Shaun. Now I'm sure you know that sugarcane gives us the sugar for our lollies, ice creams, bickies and fizzy drinks. But did you know this mighty grass does so much more?
Now hold on to your hats, because we're going on a real sugarcane train ride.
Chaka chaka choo choo, here comes a train, yeah, rolling towards the sugar cane. Cut it and load it, and off we go till the mill where sweet things flow.
We're here at Celia's farm. She's a third generation sugarcane farmer from Mirrawinnie, south of Cairns.
My family's been growing sugarcane here for about 50 years. My brother and I grew up here on the land, and I have the privilege now of teaching my girls how to grow sugarcane and look after the land. We're always doing something, whether it's planting, looking after crops, growing, even harvesting.
Chop it down when it's juicy and tall. Harvesters hum and tractors hoe. Squash it, mash it, and spin it around. So many treasures to be found. Oh.
So what makes sugarcane so special, and how do you grow something as tall as a giraffe?
Would you believe these beauties can grow up to 6 metres in height? This is in the same family as the grass family.
Wow.
Just like wheat and rice, but a whole lot taller and greener. These beauties love warm weather, lots of rain and sunshine. And with Queensland's tropical climate, perfect conditions for this versatile plant.
George, did you know sugarcane doesn't grow from a seed? Farmers plant pieces of the cane stalk called a billet into the ground, and that's what produces another sugarcane plant. How cool is that?
During planting, what we do is we cut sugarcane like this, about 30 centimetre billets. We put them in the ground, in the rows, cover it with soil, and then not long after that, little shoots will come up from the eye of the bud, and off she grows. And it takes about 15 to 16 months for it to be fully grown, for it to be harvested. And you know something else that's pretty cool, George? This crop here can regrow for about 5 to 6 years before needing to be replanted again. Yeah.
Tall and green in sunny rain, swaying fields of sugar cane. Plant a stalk and watch it sprout. Roots grow deep and shoots pop out.
Cane is tough, but it still needs a bit of TLC. That's where clever farming comes in. Joel is the Environment and Sustainability Officer with Cane Growers Australia. His job is to help farmers grow cane in ways that protect the land, water and the community.
I love helping farmers because they've got a very important job of growing food for everybody, and working with them every day outdoors like this I think is an awesome job.
Joel, what do the farmers do to look after the land and the waterways?
One thing that all growers do is around the paddocks they have special grassed areas called buffer zones. These are along the creeks and the drains, and they help to catch any soil or fertiliser that might wash off when it rains. As well as this, they'll always take soil tests before doing any fertilising to the cane crop, and this ensures they're putting on just the right amount for the cane crop to be happy and healthy without losing any fertiliser to the environment.
Farmers also use technology like GPS guided tractors to keep those rows and rows of sugarcane super straight. And they fly drones to help pinpoint any pests or disease, and to make sure every plant gets what it needs. And the work doesn't end after harvest. Every 5 to 6 years, farmers will plant a different crop where the cane had grown. This is designed to keep the soil in great shape.
One cover crop a lot of growers use around here is sun hemp. It's really good for breaking the cycle of the cane crop and helps with the soil health. And also, it's a really big crop as well, which also helps protect the soil when it rains so it doesn't wash away. And all this goes to ensure that the water is clean and healthy going into the environment for people, animals, and also the Great Barrier Reef.
Sugarcane isn't just for sugar. What other things can be made from the cane?
Sugar is the main product made from sugarcane, but there's so many other byproducts too, such as biodegradable plastics, like this water bottle here is made out of sugarcane, believe it or not. Also, there's molasses, animal feed stocks, even the trash from the cane can be used as mulch on other crops, and even some medical byproducts are made out of sugarcane as well.
Chugga chugga choo choo, here comes a train, yeah, rolling towards the sugar cane. Cut it, load it, and off we go till the mill where green dreams call.
When the cane is tall and juicy, usually between June and December, it's harvest time. Celia, George and I were wondering, how do you take all of the cane from the farm to the mill?
We have large mechanical harvesters that chop the sugar cane sticks at the base, which then goes into the trucks that take it to the loco train, that brings it to the mill, and within 15, 16 hours, it's crushed to keep it nice and fresh.
The sugar cane from Celia's farm is taken to the Mulgrave sugar mill, where it's squashed, mashed, and spun around to squeeze out every last drop of juice. That juice is then crystallised to make raw sugar. The sticky syrup left behind, called molasses, is used for animal feed and even fuel. And the leftover fibre, called bagasse, powers the whole mill and puts electricity back into the grid to help power people's homes. Now that's pretty sweet.
Sugar for treats and powerful lights, sustainable things that just feel right. Grown by sunshine, rain and hand, sugarcane's magic from our land. Oh, chaka chaka choo choo, here comes a train, yeah, rolling towards the sugarcane.
Well, George, who would have thought a tall green grass could give us so much? The next time that you have a lolly, flick on a light switch, or use a plastic bottle, just remember, it could have begun in a sugarcane field just like this one.
Thanks for joining us on our sugarcane adventure, from paddock to packet and beyond.
What do you reckon, George? Time for our next adventure?
Sugarcane's magic from our land. Chaka chaka choo choo, here comes a train, yeah, roll.